This is called Prenatal to Newborn. This is baby Bobby's point of view. Wow, for 9 months, I had a great time. My mom took naps, but I didn't have to. I just did one of two other things I'd rather do, which was to go for a swim or jump rope for a while. I didn't even have a definite bedtime because, you see, it was always dark inside of Mom's cozy tummy. The only bad thing was Mom's terrible eating habits. I could withstand the pickles and ice cream bit, but I have had enough of Mom and her peanut butter sardine sandwiches to last for a lifetime. My mom had to pick the middle of the night to eject me from my most convenient, familiar playground and presented me to the world at 3:30 in the morning. My God, what an ungodly hour. I'll admit, the man at the end of the table did get my dander up for the first thing he did. He had the nerve to slap me, and we had not even been introduced yet. True story, can you believe it? It beats me what had him so riled up in the first place to slap me when I very first came out of the chute. I don't know what had him aggravated. Well, maybe I do. Do you know the cost of electricity per kilowatt these days? You should have seen for yourself how bright it was in that room. For taking his frustrations out on me, don't worry. He'll get his deserved turn because I'm going to take advantage of him when I plan to grow up and become a super mechanic, and you won't believe the price that he's going to pay for the work that I do on his Mercedes-Benz. I knew right away I was delivered into some strange universe because everyone in this antiseptic-filled, sterile room had on a pair of squinty little red eyes. They said it was from lack of sleep, but I saw Bernie's Bar and Grill on my way, beeping down to this planet. They can't fool me. I figured out right away that they were aliens. And I still, to this day, don't know if they have limbs underneath those masks and caps and gowns and galoshes. Do you know how silly those ladies are in that place known as a hospital? They even wrote every kid's name on the end of the cot. My goodness, I already knew that my very own name in the first place, and I've known it all my life. Why put it on the end of the bed to remind me? Also, about the food here. What food? All we get is some stuff called formula. Sure, we all know that milk is a necessity for growing bones and teeth, but for nourishment, I have always been a meat and potatoes man myself. When it is bedtime, they don't even do a bath for me, and if they did, it would have the no tears formula, you know. Most of us in that observatory called a nursery were called rug rats, but I personally prefer to be known as a curtain climber. It's quite ironic, isn't it, that the nurses had permission to actually take shifts of beating us on the backs to get us to burp, when we all know burping and belching ain't mannerly. Well, I'm in the mood for complaining. Why, pray tell, wasn't something done about the scurrying around that they do here? I just get used to spitting up on one nurse, and she'd go away and bring another one. I never could make close friends with anyone at that rate. I don't mind telling you, I asked the administrator myself if something could be done in regard to all of these women looking alike. Their garments are all done in plain basic white, so boring when there's dozens of beautiful colors out there. They were about 8 weirdos with their noses pressed tightly against the clear rectangle-shaped pane in the nursery. They would not have stared that way if they realized how pig-like they looked. Besides, they shouldn't waste time comparing us kids. Everyone knows I was the best-looking kid there. Another thing. Didn't they know that it isn't polite to point? And why was everybody crying? I know that we couldn't have all looked that bad. I began to wonder, what are they up to? They bundled me up so compactly that I couldn't even move. I figured, no doubt, they plan to send me as a well-bound package to outer Siberia, or at least to see Santa at the North Pole. Oh well, that's an overprotective mother for you. Why for and how come did Mommy get to be wheeled out to the car but I didn't? Being I didn't get to ride, the nurse could have at least pushed me and my mom for a stroll, don't you think? As our car sped away, I looked back and looked out the window. I saw the nurse with a victory-clenched fist and with a scowl on her face. I read her lips as she said, "Thank God that squalling kid has been released." I wish now that when I had the chance before, I would have wept in her lap. Very soon, we had arrived at a place that my mom and dad called home. It was sure a noisy place, with an Atari computer being played by my twin brothers. The way they keep frantically screaming, one would think they're going to win the Irish sweepstakes. My teenage sister keeps the stereo turned up full blast. And how is a guy supposed to get some rest? Every time I want to lay back and take it easy, my little sister comes to my crib, slobbers fudgesicles all over my face and on my clothes, and then I get in trouble for not keeping clean. Sisters, who needs them? If I had to do it all over again, I would ask not to be irresistible. Why, you ask? You would too. If while your mom was endlessly on the phone bragging about her baby to everyone, your little brother hit you in the head with his Tonka truck. There is just no consideration where babies are concerned. My mom is stuck in a rut. She keeps changing my diaper over and over again. I try to tell her, "We already did that yesterday." And then she goes and does it again. And besides, the pamper box says up to 23 pounds. Upon occasion, I find myself saying, "Oh Lord, here comes the one they call grandmother. She has such a large frame that she no doubt looks like a lady wrestler. And one that they call Grandmother the Smotherer. She hugs me so tight that I can barely breathe to survive. That kind old man that she has with her, though, he's a great guy. He said someday we can go hunting and fishing, and I wonder if he'll be free in a couple of weeks. Last but not least, there is dear old Dad, who moans nearly all the time, especially every 10th of the month. He runs around with his fists in the air and his grasping papers, waving them frantically. Even more baffling is why he keeps ranting and raving and repeating with a disappointed, frustrated look upon his face, Bill, 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 especially when my name is Bobby." Perhaps I should not have exaggerated about all this in this story, because I love them very much, and I know that each one of them truly cares for me as I do for them. Thank you.